You're talking about what he said to the Straits Times of Singapore, and the correspondent was Leslie Lopez.
Yes.
Is that the one you're talking about?
Yeah. Yes.
Yeah, all right. Okay. Now, let me say this. I want to read one by one so that I don't make a mistake. He first claimed others played far bigger role in the financial swindle. Okay? I don't think he's telling the truth. Okay? I think he's the central figure who organized everything else around him, including the financial institutions, including the financial people like the bankers and all his cronies who are actually his accomplices. They are in 1MDB, they are in SRC, and they are also overseas. All right? But he is the central figure. So if he tried to minimize his role, he's not telling the truth. All right? And it is not surprising. All these people around him, with the exception of Goldman Sachs, the bankers and the bank, all these people around him, the accomplices together with him, have absconded. People like, I can read to you, people like Jasmine Liu, Casey Tang, Nick Faisal, Terence Gay, together with Jho Low, have absconded. The primary rule of thumb is, if you are innocent, you are only a person who exercised influence. And he said, what he said was, the board of directors, the senior management, and the shareholders, they make their own decisions. He only advised. That I agree. In fact, that is my case. What happened to the entire board of directors of SRC and 1MDB? They totally collapsed. The senior management cheated the board, and then the board say, we are not responsible because the shareholders were calling the shot. That is turning company law upside down. But that is as far as I can agree with Jho Low. He's right on that. But Jho Low conveniently forget to tell us that he actually misled the senior management. Some of the senior management worked with Jho Low, in fact, accomplices of Jho Low. And he misled SRC, the board, and he misled the 1MDB companies. Okay? So he is the number one central culprit, if I can say. This is number one. He's the number one crook. Okay? So for him to say he's just a victim, he says, you know, he's a victim because he's not a politician. That's totally a rubbish, because if you are not a politician, nobody would want to victimize you, because you're a non-politician. So because you're a non-politician, you should turn up. It is only politician who gets into trouble, because there is a counter politician who wants to put you into trouble. But if Jho Low is not a politician, it goes against his argument that he's being bullied. That's total rubbish. He is not being bullied. He is, in fact, I'm surprised that the Malaysian authorities have not gone very hard to find him. The IGP made promises 6 months ago that he'll get Jho Low within 2 weeks. Very strong statement he made. Until today, the IGP has not made even announcement where is Jho Low. Why can't they go hard against Jho Low? And not only Jho Low, what about these 4 or 5 accomplices that I've said? Why not go after them? Why not announce where Jho Low is, and then name and shame the country who you know where Jho Low is and have not responded to our authorities' legal requests for Jho Low to be arrested and sent back? I want to know why Malaysia has not done any request for extradition. Where are these? They've been talking all the time. All our authorities have been talking, but doing nothing. Who stand to lose? This country stand to lose. We are losing a lot of money. The wrong doers are not being punished. And my client, Datuk Seri Najib, is not getting the best defense because these people are absent. So is it purposely done to deprive my client of the best defense, because these are witnesses that my client can use in order to interrogate them by way of cross-examination and to prove my client's case. Without these people, now it is only my client telling his version. Now, then he said, he was surprised the media scrutinizes on him, let go the financial institutions and so on and so on. He's again not telling the truth. The media scrutinize on him because they know he is the main person. The others, like Goldman Sachs, I must tell you about Goldman Sachs. Why Goldman Sachs and the bankers are the only people who never ran away, like Jho Low? Goldman Sachs and the bankers are as crookish, rogue as Jho Low. I'm not saying the whole bank, but I'm saying certain personalities in the bank, the bankers. Why didn't they run away? Because Goldman Sachs always know. The personalities, they always know. They are so powerful, they will be protected. If they get hammered, they will get a slap on their wrist, like you now know. A couple of their bankers made some arrangement, pleaded guilty here and there, got nothing much. They should be slammed in the slammer, in the jail, for many years, perhaps with the key thrown away, because of what they have committed together with Jho Low against this country. But you notice Goldman Sachs escaped with virtually nothing. It's just a financial punishment. And they got other huge sum of money in their keeping. So they benefited even by this punishment. And now you realize Jho Low is trying to do the same thing. You know Jho Low is negotiating for $1 billion return to US for him to be, no more a hunted man in US. Now you tell me, if you are innocent, why you want to negotiate $1 billion with the US? Where did you get this $1 billion? $1 billion is more than 4 billion Malaysian money. Where did you get this money from? You didn't get this money from your grandparents or your father. Where did you get this money from? You should explain. So Jho Low is a person whose credibility is gone. Yeah, he's now trying to spin story because he thinks after US, he settled the US matter, his reputation might be okay. But I'm afraid that is not on. It's not going to be as easy as that, okay? But I think he timed his statement after 4 years of silence because of what he anticipated to be happening in the US. Maybe after he settled with the US, he may want to make an application to be in US. I don't know. But he's playing hide and seek with the authorities. He's playing hide and seek with the reporters. Nobody seems to know where he is. People guess he is mainly in China, not in Emirates. Emirates is just a red herring so that people look at for him in the wrong places. Yeah. So I think this statement that he made to the Straits Times of Singapore is another big red herring. It's just purely to whip up sentiments in favor of him and to find some element of mercy for him to be forgiven in some way or other and to be forgotten. Okay, but I don't think that's going to happen. As long as he's not put on trial, especially in Malaysia, this will be a living story forever.